Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology. And I had made the videos on Ashtakvarga, and so many of you have asked me different questions. And today I will try to address around 10 to 15 questions, and I will try my best to fit in the technical stuff here. But you may not understand everything what I speak here, so it is essential that you check out the videos on Ashtakvarga which I have made recently in 1 or 2 months. So by that you will get an understanding of how to see. I have made for different events like marriage and career and all other things. And on Kakshaya slot, which is very important, there's one video coming up with Nitin Kashyapji. I already recorded it. It is in Hindi and English. So that video also, you will get it the next day, tomorrow. And on Mahadashas, I have also made a video. That's a very long video, almost 40 minutes. That also you will get by this weekend. So it's full Ashtakvarga stuff during this weekend. So therefore, those two questions I will not be addressing here, Dashas and Kakshaya slot, that you can see. And apart from that, so many other queries I will try my best to answer here. These are unanswered Ashtakvarga queries, or some of them may be answered also, or frequently asked. All right. So as usual, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your chart or your Ashtakvarga, you can always go down to my website down in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So the first question is, where can I find my Ashtakvarga report or scores for free? Yes, you can get it in astrosage.com. So when you go to Astrosage, nothing else you have to do, just make a kundli. And if you keep skimming through it, you will see the Ashtakvarga scores, okay? Which house is having how many points, that you will have it, all right? Then the next question is, and yes, this you can have it for free, and there is no, you don't need to log in or any registration or nothing else is required. Just go there and do it. Everybody knows Astrosage, I guess it's very popular. Or it might be available in other websites also, but I'm not aware. So Astrosage I know, and you can get it. You can see everything there, all right? Bhinna Ashtakvarga, Sarva Ashtakvarga, everything you can see there. So it's a great thing to have it. So please go and see your report, all right? All right, the next query is, I have less than 28 points in a particular house. So does it mean, is it good? Sorry, does it mean that it is bad? And if it is 28, does it mean the house is okay, so-so? Or if it is more than 28, does it mean that the house, that house is great? Well, actually, what is 28? 28 is basically almost like the average of all the points. Okay, if you take all the points that you get and then you divide by 12, then almost you get around 28. So having 28 points, or having 35 points, or having 20 points has nothing to do with the good or bad stuff in the house. It all depends, I will tell you, it all depends on who are the planets that are contributing to that house. So let me give you an example. Suppose somebody's seventh house has 18 points, right? So according to this definition of 28, that should be terrible. But suppose the lord of the seventh house, second and the 11th, these three houses, the house of marriage and 5 and 9, the trines which help marriage, if these houses, the lords of these houses are contributing maximum to those 18 points, you will have the most amazing, wonderful and fantastic married life ever. But now suppose you have 35 points and the lord of the sixth house is contributing quite a bit there, and the lord of the eighth house is contributing, and at times the 10th lord also, or the 12th lord, then that 35 points can create lots and lots and lots of challenges in your marriage. So therefore, it is not who is contributing how much. It is who is that planet, who is that lord, right? Because planets always carry agenda of their lordships. Always remember this. So they can never get rid of their agenda. They can never forget their agenda. Everybody has their own agenda. So therefore, it's essential that we judge them through the lordships and also the natural significations of the planets. Okay. So we should not just think that, okay, less than 28 is bad or more than 28 is good. So it is not like that. So similarly for the 10th house, if the planets like the 2nd, 10th lord, 6th lord, 11th lord contribute to these houses, the lords of these houses contribute in Ashtakvarga maximum to these houses, to each other, then fantastic for finances, great career, amazing name, fame, reputation, money. But if it is not, then well, may not be that. All right, so we have to use this very cautiously, and the nature of the planets will also tell the flavor of that house. Okay, so one is the quantity, another is the quality. All right, so the next question that you asked me is, should we use Ashtakvarga when we are reading horoscopes, or can we give a reading only based on Ashtakvarga? Well, of course we can do that. We must use readings. We must use Ashtakvarga when we are doing readings. Without using Ashtakvarga, you will never be able to understand what is actually going on in the chart. So Ashtakvarga is very, very, very important. So therefore, you will see many exalted planets, Mahapurush Yoga, blah, 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 all the stuff. But this is a missing clue which people don't use or people don't realize. And the biggest advantage of Ashtakvarga is it can quickly give you a view on what will make you happy in life. All right, so what is that which you should do or what you can do? Yes, these kind of things. Generally, it's very difficult to answer from the horoscope. We can answer, but still it's very difficult because there are so many things in a chart. But Ashtakvarga can give us a quick viewpoint of what should be done and when, what the person should do in the dashas also. Okay. And there can be contradictions about which I will come. There is another question related to that. And as you had asked me, do I use Ashtakvarga in my readings, consultations? Of course I do. And more than hundreds and so many, I don't know, uncounted, so many mails I have got for Ashtakvarga readings. So long time back, in fact, not very long time, I would say recently I had a new option in my website. Only Ashtakvarga. For career and for marriage. All right. So if you are interested, you can go to my website to book a reading only if you want the Ashtakvarga analysis. But in all other readings also, I use Ashtakvarga. So it's not that only to and see, it's like both the ways, you know, when you are used to giving Ashtakvarga reading, you cannot just see Ashtakvarga. You have to see the other things. So similarly, when you are giving a general reading, then also you have to consider Ashtakvarga. So it's not like either this or that. It's not like that. It is always both, but it depends on where you want to focus. Okay. The next question: what is most important in Ashtakvarga? This is a very important question. Question number 4. So the most important thing is to see which planets are contributing how much to your ascendant. That is the most important thing. That will tell you what are those issues which will always, they will always bog you in a good way or a bad way, either ways you call it. So for example, if suppose somebody's sixth lord is contributing the highest to the lagna. So that means inherently this person is not very much interested to get married, or inherently he could have challenges in married life. This is an inherent meaning. But now suppose in his 7th house, there are 28 points, for example, and then the 2nd lord, 7th lord, and 11th lord are contributing greatly to the 7th house. Okay, so then what this could mean? This could mean that the person's married life is fine, but he's not very much into it because his lagna is been lagna in the lagna, the sixth lord, which is the lord of celibacy and staying single, not getting into marriage or relationship, that is contributing higher. So that flavor will always be there. Okay. But suppose now the other way around, suppose somebody's sixth lord is activated, but in the ascendant, the seventh lord or the second lord is contributing huge, great, too many points. Okay. So then it could be the opposite. Then it could mean that the sixth lord is giving him celibacy, which is no marriage, but the person always wants to get married. Okay. So that is how you know what is most important. So the ascendant will define the theme of the entire Ashtakvarga scores or all the houses. And therefore, it is the most important. So after that, you have to check the ascendant lord. So ascendant lord's Ashtakvarga. So ascendant lord means, suppose you have Venus. So you have to see two things. Wherever Venus is placed, who is contributing there, and Venus alone is contributing where. Okay, so that also you have to see which houses Venus is giving how many points and who are giving Venus points. Okay, because Venus will sit in a particular house and every planet will give points to that house. Okay, so again this is becoming blur. Okay, yeah, now it's good again. And then you have to check sun and moon. So these four things, ascendant lord, sun and moon. All right, so these four things. And specifically, you can check 10th lord for career or the 10th house, the 11th house, 2nd house, 6th house, 10th house. All right, these houses for marriage, the 2nd, 5th, 7th, 9th, and 11th. So like that, you will know which are the most important areas you need to focus. So start with these four, ascendant lord, sun and moon, and then later move ahead. So without analyzing these four, you should never analyze Ashtakvarga. All your predictions will fail. All right. Now, next is individual points for events. So this is something which I already covered. So for example, you have the second lord, which contributes quite a number of points. So suppose you are a Scorpio Lagna, then Venus is your seventh lord, Jupiter is your second lord. And second house is family, seventh house is marriage. They are always complementary. So now suppose Jupiter is contributing and Jupiter has the highest amount number of points. So therefore, if Jupiter contributes to Taurus, your seventh house, high, big number of points, so maybe 8 points. Okay, so that is fantastic for your married life. Okay, because that shows in the married life, in your marriage, the sense of family and togetherness is very much there. And now suppose Venus contributes to Sagittarius. What does this mean? This means that whenever you think of family, you know, marriage is important to you. So both are like complementary. Marriage is important in family. Family is important in marriage. So they are very complementary. Okay? So that's how you have to combine all the things. Okay, don't just see the seventh house. You also have to check the second and 11th. And for love affairs, I already made that video, you know, fifth house, and you have to check the ascendant and other things. How much is the person interested in getting married to somebody who he loves? Okay, it's not necessary that everybody is. So that you have to see from the Ashtakvarga. I know you have to see how much is the fifth lord and seventh lord contributing to each other and to the ascendant, and like that you have to analyze. So you could watch that video. You will get to know what I'm talking about. I made it on love affairs, and I also made it for marriage and for career also. Next question, number 6, transits. How to use transits. I made a detailed video on transits. Please watch it. So in that I said, you know, that so suppose Jupiter is transiting somebody's fifth house. So then, I mean, currently in transit, it's in fifth house, suppose, for somebody. Then what happens is, you have to check in the original birth chart, what is Jupiter's agenda, where he is giving how many points. So by that, you will know how much of that flavor will come to the fifth house. Because without seeing that, if you just see, oh, fifth house has 30 points, okay, I will have children. No, that's that is going to be catastrophe. It is going to be a, I mean, forget about it. So please watch the transits video. And the next is about dasha. So the dasha video you will get very soon, in the next 2 days. Then Kakshaya slot, question number 8. Nitin ji has very kindly spoken about it. So you will get that video also, hopefully tomorrow or day after. Then the next question is divisional charts. Should we use Ashtakvarga and divisional charts? Well, in my experience, I have not used it. And I'm not saying that you don't have to use. You could still use. But if you ask me, it becomes too much complicated. Okay? Because divisional charts are to be studied differently. And now, if you have that much time and that much availability of resources that you can go to divisional charts and see the Ashtakvarga and all this, then you can do that. There's no harm in that. Nobody will punish you for that. But at a practical level, it becomes very difficult, because divisional charts are like another reading in itself, and then reading Ashtakvarga of the divisional charts and then combining it. But yes, if somebody has a very specific questions, so suppose somebody wants to know only about marriage, then you can also see the Navamsha, and then you can try to link the Ashtakvarga. Okay, that you can do. That's perfectly fine. But you have to limit yourself, because otherwise you will get confused. You will see that, oh, here this is saying this, here this is saying that, right? So for example, suppose in your Lagna chart, the second lord is contributing, maybe again the same example, Scorpio Lagna, Jupiter is the second lord, he's contributing 8 points to Taurus, seventh house. Okay, but now suppose now this is the Lagna chart, but suppose in the Navamsha the sixth lord is contributing maximum to the seventh house. So then how do you fathom, or how do you resolve this contradiction? Well, this can mean that externally your family is always focused. Oh, how is your married life? Your mother, father is asking, oh, marriage is good, bad. But internally, you know, that connection is not there, because you feel as if I'm single. Because in the Navamsha, it's showing like that, all right? And then other things also matter, of course. So this is one way you can try to correlate them. Okay? Or sometimes it can be the other way around, that your family is not interested in your marriage, but you yourself are very much family oriented and committed towards your partner and the marriage. Then it's the other way around, all right? But you can use it and there's no harm. Then the next thing is conflicts. Okay, so now the biggest conflict happens is, so suppose somebody's fifth house is activated in dashas. So then what happens? If the person is married, then there's a possibility that the person might have children. But now suppose the fifth lord or the second lord or the 11th lord or the 9th lord, these are houses of family and children and lineage, they are not contributing much to the fifth house. Or suppose the lord of the fifth house itself is not contributing much. Then what happened? Then what will happen? Will the person have children or will the person not have children? Well, the person will have children, because whatever dasha indicates ultimately happens. But you will not be able to rejoice in that event. You will feel that, okay, child is born, that's it. I mean, this can happen for any house, not only childbirth. If it's for career, then anytime you get promotions, you will feel, okay, what's so big about it? What is the big deal? But suppose the Lagna Lord has great contribution to the fifth house, then, and the fifth Lord also contributes to the fifth house, and then the fifth Lord or the planet in the fifth house gets active, then it's like bang on, you are like, you're dancing, jumping, and you are giggling, and oh, it was a boy, it was a girl, or, I mean, everybody can see that, you know, you are in the heavens, right? So that is how you have to resolve conflicts. Number 11, can we see other people from Ashtakvarga, from our own Ashtakvarga? Can we see that? Well, you can see, but again, that's that makes things much more complicated. Please don't do it. See the individual chart, which means if you have your mother, go and check her chart and check her Ashtakvarga. Don't try to check, okay, my fourth lord is here, it is giving these many points. Yeah, you can see one thing if suppose your fourth lord is contributing to the sixth house, then it can happen that your mother can interfere in your marriage and that might lead to issues in your marriage. Or if it is contributing to the seventh house, then it can happen that the mother has a very big say in your marriage, which means the mother may find the spouse for you. These kind of things can happen. If the ninth lord, then father, 11th lord, then friends, you know, these kind of things. If third lord is involved in the seventh, then it can happen that you meet your spouse through online media, these kind of things, or in short distance travel. But it is still not a very good idea to give an entire analysis of your mother, father, or husband, wife only using Ashtakvarga. It is not a very good idea. You will not see great results there, all right? So use the lords as the relatives as how they may impact your life, not how they are getting impacted in their lives, okay? So now, for example, your ninth lord may contribute to the seventh house quite a bit. Then maybe your father is very much interested in your marriage, but maybe in his chart, his Lagna Lord is contributing to the sixth house more. So that means it's like he's interested in your marriage, but he's not interested in his own marriage. It's like that. Okay. I know it's very complicated, but that's how life is and people are complex. So exaltation versus debilitation. So suppose a planet is exalted, does it mean that the Ashtakvarga multiplies or something? No, nothing like this. The same rule is the exaltation is awareness, knowledge. Okay, so if a planet is exalted, then you are well aware of how to use those traits. Okay, now whether you will use it or not, that is dependent on the whole chart, and you have to see how other planets are helping or obstructing that planet. Okay, that is why you will see lakhs and millions of people have Mahapurush Yogas or Raj Yogas, but they are not able to use them properly. Okay. And for exaltation, debilitation, you also have to check the strength of ascendant lord, sun and moon and the karakas for that house. Okay. So for example, your seventh lord is exalted. Then you also have to check what is the situation of Venus and Jupiter, who are the two natural karakas for the seventh house. Okay. So if 10th lord is exalted, you also have to check where is Saturn, Mercury and Sun, these three primarily. All right. And then you analyze the Ashtakvarga. That will give you more finer clues. Okay, so don't use Ashtakvarga in seclusion of planetary dignity. Okay. So, for example, suppose some let's take a situation. If seventh lord is in debility, but there are contributions from the second or fifth or ninth to the seventh, so then it can happen that your family members and your children, they are helping you in the marriage. Okay. But because your seventh lord is in debility, your own awareness to deal with problems in marriage is very low, and there you suffer, you see. So that's how life is. Always some planet will be afflicted or debilitated, or in Dusthana or Kambast or in debility, or some house which is not very conducive to a particular house will be contributing points there. So that's how life is, unfortunately, or fortunately. All right, so Rahu Ketu, how do you see Rahu Ketu? Very complicated. No, not at all. Just see the houses where they are placed. Okay, so if Rahu is in second house, analyze the second house. Ketu is in the eighth house, analyze the eighth house. Okay, so no complication there. Very simple, just analyze them. But the only difference is they don't... they are not participating in the system directly, but they are sitting in the horoscope, so they are sitting in a particular house. Okay. Next question: conjunctions. How to see conjunctions in Ashtakvarga? Well, you can see them. So, for example, suppose as I gave this example, suppose the ninth lord and fifth lord are conjunct in the seventh house. Okay. Not seventh house, I would say. Maybe if suppose the second lord is conjunct the ninth lord in the fifth house. So then it can happen that, and now if you go to Ashtakvarga, then you have to see the Ashtakvarga of the second lord. Okay, and you have to check in the fifth house who is contributing how much. How much is the second lord contributing? Who is sitting there? How much is the ninth lord who is sitting is contributing? So by that you will know who will have a stronger say in the marriage, in the childbirth. Okay. Now there's the tricky situation. Suppose the ninth lord contributes more, but he's in debility, and the second lord maybe he's exalted or something like this. Okay. I mean, I'm just giving an example, of course, or using a better dignity. So then what do you do? So there you have to use the principles which I told you earlier for exaltation and debilitation. And aspects. What about aspects? So suppose a particular house has, let's take seventh house for example. So suppose the lagna of a person is heavily contributed by the sixth house, and a planet is sitting there who is also contributing to the sixth house. And then if it aspects the seventh house, is it good or bad for marriage? Well, individually, it might be challenging for marriage, but for that, you have to see what the dashas are telling. All right. So all this theory is fine, but when you give practical predictions of what is going to happen, you have to check the dashas and the dasha planets, and that video you will see in the next 2 days. So then you know how to ultimately give a practical prediction, not just, your third lord is contributing to seventh house, so your wife will come from some social media, Facebook or YouTube, something. It's not like that. Okay. You know that the inclination is very strong. The person will be wanting to chat with other members of the opposite sex and then take it towards marriage. But if the dasha is indicating something else, then you have to check what the dasha is indicating. And then you have to try to merge both of them. Okay, so it's the same. So for example, if suppose Saturn is in Libra for somebody, exalted in Kendra, it's forming Sasama Purush Yoga. But suppose now Sun is in a particular house from where Saturn is in 12th. Okay, so suppose Sun is in Scorpio, or Saturn is in Dusthan from there. So then what will happen? Will you see the results of the Mahapurush Yoga? How will you see that? So similarly, you have to analyze, okay, what is going on in the chart. Practically, you have to analyze with dashas, and then you have to place transits over that. So don't read charts in isolation and then just give some fancy predictions. You know, fifth lord contributes to the seventh, you will have love marriage. But what if the dasha of the fifth house is not coming? First you check if the dasha of the seventh house is coming or second house, then only the person will get married. Then you check if the fifth house is involved in the dasha planets. Without that, what is the use of Ashtakvarga? If dasha is not permitting, then I mean, there's no love, there's no marriage, nothing is there, right? The person may be working 24 hours. He may be staying in the office, not coming home. Then how does he get married? So using Ashtakvarga is fine, but you must use the dashas, and there also you have to use Ashtakvarga, all right? That is all from my side. And if you have any other questions, and somebody has asked me about combustion or affliction, it's all the same. There's no fancy rule. It's the same, all right? There you go. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me, then you can always go down to the description section. And God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. All right. Thank you so much. And stay tuned for Nitinji's video and my video on the Dashas. All right. Thank you. Bye-bye.